Top stories from around the island. To the point. Without the fluff. Puerto Rico headline news. Please subscribe and don't forget to hit the bell notification. Daphne Barbato, spokesman for the Tourism Alliance of Puerto Rico, and Luis Malave, president of the Employees Union of the Ports Authority, urged the government to stop the proposed agreement to establish a public-private partnership (PPP) with the Global Ports Holdings (GPH) company. The lack of transparency and apparent secrecy of the negotiated agreement forced the creation of this new alliance, which resulted in a press conference that was held today. The press conference was used to denounce the lack of transparency in the process of privatization of the docks and to draw attention to this most important industry. Taxi drivers, merchants, union employees of the Port Authority and travel agencies met this morning in front of Pier 3 in Old San Juan to denounce the lack of transparency with which the government has entered into negotiations with GPH. Their message was clear: a complete rejection of the privatization of cruise ship docks to GPH and a demand that discussions be resumed to include the participation of all interested parties. As explained by Daphne Barbato, spokesman for the Tourism Alliance of Puerto Rico, the most serious concerns raised revolve around the lack of details of the GPH proposal, particularly if the company seeks to monopolize taxi, excursion, restaurant, and entertainment services. This can potentially cause a negative impact on the 30,000 direct jobs in the industry and the $70 million spent by tourists locally. In order to imagine a worst-case scenario, the members of the alliance pointed to the ports of Cozumel and Riviera Maya in Mexico, where cornered shopping centers were created in the area near the docks. This type of model would limit the tourist economic activity in the entire walled city and hinder travel excursions. We have to believe that, if this is what is happening, it will force or lay the groundwork for the government to make this public-private partnership. But if it were so good for Puerto Rico, why do they have to make it confidential? Barbato said. From the government's point of view, the Port Authority AP insists that the proposed concession for a term of 30 years to GPH answers the need to make infrastructure improvements to the docks, a task for which the agency does not have the funds to execute it. The AP faces a debt of $456 million, which makes the potential transaction a very attractive one, but the negotiations are secret and have remained between the Public-Private Partnerships Authority (AAPP), the tourism company (CTPR), and the Fortaleza, without participation of the members of the Tourist Alliance. Pamela Calderon, president of the Old San Juan Merchants Association, said she had made many previous attempts to speak with former AP Executive Director Anthony Macera to clarify the details of the agreement. However, those involved in the negotiations have reiterated that these are confidential negotiations. She expects that the government will keep the agreement confidential even when it is ratified, which will only worsen the atmosphere of uncertainty that the proposed agreement has created. We have not been given the tools to know if they are complying or not. We do not have the tools to know if the agreement will affect us or not because we have not been told. Definitely the worst for an economy of any country is uncertainty because of the lack of information, said Calderon. The only detail that the alliance does have is the knowledge of the cancellation of just over 100 cruise departures from the Royal Caribbean line for the season of April 2021 until 2022. This will result in a loss of $40 million to the local economy that would normally be spent by visiting passengers. We need professionals from the tourism sector to make decisions for the tourist sector. We cannot continue to allow people that are family members or because they have a particular political link to make executive decisions about something that will affect 70,000 jobs, said Juan Fernandez, vice president of the Merchant Association of Old San Juan (ACOVI). Thanks for watching. Please support this channel by subscribing, liking, and sharing our content. We look forward to providing a live, English-based newscast in the near future for Puerto Rico headline news.